What's up, guys? Well, the fight's just ended a few minutes ago. The overrated PBC heavyweights pull out victories and continue on. Man, oh man. You know, in my video where I talked about the odds for the Deontay Wilder-Gerald Washington fight, you know, I talked about the reasons why I was, you know, taking the value play, the high odds with Gerald Washington. You know, I said a lot of things, but I held back. You know, I held back, and I shouldn't have. I talked about Deontay's deficiencies. I talked about his injuries and all that kind of stuff. Okay. A word that I should have used that I will use now. I should have used then, and I apologize, but I'm going to use it now. Deontay Wilder is overrated. There's no other way to say it. There's no other way to put it. I don't think I said it in that video. Maybe I said it in a different video. I'm not sure, but I felt that he was getting outboxed by Arthur Spilker, okay? In this fight tonight, Deontay Wilder was losing in a clean sweep. I did not score one round for Deontay Wilder. Okay, he got the fifth round knockout. You know, Gerald Washington was outboxing Deontay. Before I did that odds video, I looked at, you know, just like a handful of minutes of Gerald Washington. I had never seen the guy before. I didn't know what he looked like. Okay, I saw that the guy had a Mayweather style, you know, style with his defense, with the way he covered his body. The shell, you know, I was like, man, this guy is, he is a heavyweight that is boxing like a boxer, like a smaller guy, you know. I saw what he could do. I saw the type of IQ that he had and that he used. And I thought, hey, this guy has a legit shot just from what I saw in those clips, okay, and that he had 12 knockouts on his record, okay. I'm sitting here, you know, kind of on pins and needles because on a value play, you know, small risk, high reward. Gerald Washington was on the way of making me good money tonight. Good money tonight off a small play. And he was winning. He was cruising in this fight. When he was successful, he was in the middle of the ring. He used the jab. He had Deontay on the back foot, as I talked about him being on the back foot. Deontay was against the ropes. He was not throwing much at all throughout the fight. You know, until he landed the punches in the fifth round to finish the show. You know, he was doing nothing, man. And that was Gerald Washington's fight. And in the fourth round, he started to slip. He started, for some reason, he lost his position in the middle of the ring, and he started having his back on the ropes, you know. And I believe in between the fourth and the fifth, I didn't go back to hear it, but I believe in between those rounds, his trainer, his corner man, was telling him to stay in the middle of the ring. Do not, you know, do not give up that position because Deontay was not doing anything. He wasn't doing anything, you know. I think that's what the guy was saying. It was kind of hard to make out because, you know, they didn't have the mic directly on the guy. But I think he was telling him to stay in the middle of the ring. Do not give up that position. And at the end of the fight, what happened? Gerald Washington had his back on the ropes. Right there for Deontay to tee off on, you know. He is going to look back at this and he's going to realize that he made a big mistake. You know, I guess this was what the inexperience factor did. But, you know, I thought a guy like this, Deontay, had been struggling and not putting away the Eric Molinas and this other guy, the Duopie or whatever his name is, and Arthur Spilker, these type guys, man. You know, I figured he'd get in there with this big half-Mexican, half-African-American brother who had boxing skills. You know, it could possibly give him fits, a guy who had power. The game plan is laid out for Deontay Wilder, man. Stay in the middle of the ring, make him stay on the back foot, make him go back toward the ropes, and use a great jab, and you can beat this guy, okay? Stay in the middle of the ring and jab, you know. For some reason, Gerald Washington gave up that position, and he paid for it, man. And he is going to regret this shit for a long time, okay? You know, Gerald, you was doing good, man. But you know, just made a big mistake at the end. And like I said, in the heavyweight division, it only takes one shot. That's why I thought Washington was a good value play because of the power. You know, it only takes one shot. Deontay had the injuries and stuff. You know, and he got caught with that punch, and he could not recover. At first, I thought the ref stopped that shit way too soon. But I guess apparently he didn't. You know, I didn't see any better camera angles other than what was originally shown. But commentators apparently said that it looked like he was out of it. You know, he was still on wobbly legs. So, you know, sucks. You know, it was a value play. This was not one to bet the house on, one that we expected to lose. But, you know, this guy was winning this fight, man, the clean sweep till he got caught, you know. So congrats Deontay Wilder, Gerald, man. You know, lesson learned, man. Lesson learned. This guy will be back, you know. I think he will be back. You know, match him up well, get him some more wins, more experience, and he can make another push for a title, you know. And by the way, in the future, I'm pretty sure, depending on the opponents, we'll be able to get high odds against Deontay Wilder again. I will be taking those high odds, okay? I will be taking those high odds. That was one of the reasons why I wanted to play Gerald Washington. You know, Deontay's a bit overrated. These high odds, man. I get the feeling one day he's going to be upset, you know. You know, if he's fighting these type of guys before he fights, say, Anthony Joshua, man, look, Anthony Joshua, man, it's not going to go well for Deontay. I'm sorry, but, you know, Anthony Joshua is going to be a nightmare unless he lands a solid punch. Anthony Joshua is infamous for being just staying in the middle of the ring, keeping his position, keeping his spot, and throwing his jab, throwing his punches. And he is going to give Deontay Wilder fits, man, unless Deontay throws and lands a hell of a punch on Anthony Joshua, okay? Now, the co-main event is Harrison Hurd. Let me tell you, I was not paying all court attention to this fight. I was not scoring this fight. I figured Harrison was winning this fight, and I was hoping that he did win this fight. I only thought two things when I was watching this fight. One, neither one of these guys can beat Laura or Andre. Okay, that's number one. Number two, Kell Brook and Eddie Hearn. I will be tweeting this video to those guys. You know, I know Kell has business with Errol Spence. But after he beats Errol Spence, you guys may want to consider, you know, talking to the IBF about getting a title shot against this guy, Hurd, who was losing the fight pretty handily until he came back and got a stoppage, okay? You know, guy got up and spit his mouthpiece out. I mean, what do you expect is going to happen? I don't blame the ref for stopping that fight. That was a quit move, okay? And I was hoping Harrison would win the fight because he was, like, the smaller guy. And I was like, shit, if Kell wants to move up and get a title at 154, this the guy to do it. But hey, they can get Hurd, offer him a nice chunk of money to come over to Sheffield, or come to London or wherever, and you know, Kell can get that belt at 154. Okay, that's my opinion. That's my feeling on that. And hell, he ain't got to drop the IBF welterweight title. Shit, have them both. Hell, but yeah, that's a fight they need to take if they want to go to 154. This is a great opportunity to get that belt from this guy, you know. And the fight of the night was the opening fight. Dominic Breazeale, who I'm not high on at all, who I think is not that good, and he was proven to be. When I was watching the fight, I was thinking, I was like, man, I should look into this fight. I should have, you know, because I don't think high this guy. I should have played this fight, but guess it's good I didn't because he ended up having a comeback KO. You know, this guy, Ugonoh or whatever his name was, man, was out boxing Breazeale, hitting him in that big fat stomach. You know, he was doing what he was supposed to, doing what he needed to do. And, you know, he ended up wanting to get in a firefight, and then he got caught and knocked down in what was it, the third round, I believe. And Breazeale got that round. In the next round, he knocked Breazeale down, you know, and then it wasn't the fifth, I guess it was. Breazeale caught him and finished him off, man, knocked him out. So, you know, Breazeale was on his way to losing, but heavyweight division, it only takes one shot, man. You know, Max Kellerman, You know, saying people don't have 0.00% chance of shit. It only takes one shot, man. It's the fight game, you know. And, you know, Breazeale, who I thought was going to lose that fight, who I was ready to laugh at and clown, you know, he landed the shot, knocked the guy out. And he's going to live to fight another day. And lesson learned for Ugonoh or whatever his name is, okay? And that's my impressions on tonight's fight, guys. You know, man, I don't know who all out there played the Gerald Washington value, but man, I thought we were on our way. I don't know what the scorecards was, but I was thinking to myself, man, this shit in Alabama, it would not surprise me if they tried to rob this man if he went to a decision. Because the way it was looking, man, like he was about to sweep Deontay's ass, man. I'm telling you, Deontay, I'm not holding back on the overrated word now. I point out his flaws, talked about his injuries and all that. I did not use the word overrated, but now, man, I'm telling you, when his name is on the board, look at that play. Look at the odds. If you get great value on the other side, it is worth playing, man. You know, Deontay was not doing anything in that fight until he landed the punch that put Washington down the first time. You know, he was on the back foot, not throwing anything, getting jabbed to death in the middle of the ring. Washington gave up his position and paid for it, man. Paid for it. I remember when he first was getting up on the ropes, I guess that was in the fourth round, I was like, man, why are you getting up on the ropes? Get away from the ropes. You know, you right there for him to tee off on, you know. Shit, ask Arthur Spilker, you know, his back was up near the ropes, you know. So, telling you guys, you know, could have had a great upset tonight, but, you know, Gerald Washington didn't come through. So, that's it for tonight, guys. Hope you enjoyed the fights. I guess it was okay. All three fights finished in a knockout. So, yeah, I guess can't complain too much. Ain't no screwdriver decisions going on tonight. So, that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll be checking in with you guys soon, man. Take care.